Hey everybody, welcome back. We are getting ready to do some more acrylic pouring. As you can see, getting ready for a little bit of luck with some horseshoes. St. Patrick's Day is quickly coming up on us, and so I wanted to have at least 3 or 4 horseshoes to put up on the magnet board for sale, but we're going to go ahead and do several, and I'll probably put the magnets right about there, location wise. Forgot about the dehumidifier. Hold on. Heard that sucker kick on. I was like, oh, I'm gonna have to yell. I picked as much of the dry part of paint up as I could. This right here is still wet, those spots, so we'll have to let them dry some more. But that's what that is. It's still drying. I need to pick a day to sit down and put the camera up close and just pick the paint off the tablecloth and do a little ASMR for y'all. I don't know when I'll get around to doing that. All right, so some lucky horseshoes. I'm going to use up my, or not going to finish using them up, but this is a good project to use up my pouring acrylic colors from Arteza. These are ready pours, and I don't have too many projects where I actually use the ready pour, because when I mix it with my other paints, it does a speckled kind of thing. So this is a good one to go ahead and use up some of these paints on. I've got another box of them yet to use up, so we're gonna slowly get there. But we're going to do different colors. Some are going to be pastel. Some are going to be a little more bold. I'm going to do some in our high school colors. Our high school colors are dark green and dark yellow, Trojan and Spartan colors. So hopefully one of them will sell. We'll go from there. But let's go ahead and just start decorating and pouring. And so the top part is going to be blow pour. And then to do the backs, I'm going to dip them like I did the snowflakes, some of the snowflakes. We're going to dip those and then let the backside dry. And then both sides will look nice. I did kind of mix these up earlier, so hopefully they're all shooken up real good. And the only metallic color I have is bronze, which is what came with the kit, and I just figured I'm going to keep it. Well, I've got metallic silver I could use also. These bottles are also hard to pour just a little bit out of. I'm going to try that again. I don't like how this part ended up. All right, let's do the next batch. I'm not going to put any metallic on that one. It's almost too faint, isn't it? Right. I'm going to do that one again. I'm not liking it. I don't know what exactly it is, but let's go ahead and just put a good base down again. We can have some yellow in there, that's fine with me. Thank you. like that at that. I wish the stripes were a little more prominent, but they might come out a little bit more as it dries. We'll see. This one's going to be similar to the other one right above it. See the glue coming out the seams. All right, that's a lot of purple, so let's mix some pink and blue in that. That mixed a little bit better. It might have been pointless to do that white. We'll see what I get. I actually like that. I've got to clean one of these that I'm going to put these all on, and hopefully that keeps the under surface drying nicely. This yellow I'm not too scared of. It's the Amsterdam, I forget the exact name, but it's the deep yellow. We'll add some light yellow just to blend in, because otherwise it's a lot of green. a little Starry Night. So that's a mix of the two brands, and it's already clouding. The effect worked. Not what I was aiming for, but the effect looks good. So we are going to leave that alone, and let's do some more. Let's bring you all in for a closer look, and then I'll move them over to the cleaner mat. So starting with the first one that we did. You kind of see the colors there. So some are faint and some are bold. A little bit of lacing. I love this color combo. The green base with the light and the dark yellow. You can see some of the lacing on that spot there. Some pastel colors, some bolder colors, sky. This one's definitely sky looking here. I didn't worry about that other side because it kind of works having it that way, composition wise. And last but not least, you can see the effects I was talking about with the red. Here's a dry picture. Thank you all for joining me on this one. I'll see you on the next one. Bye.